क्वेश्चन नंबर 27 इज द पॉइंट ऑन द कर्व एक्स स्क्वायर इक्वल टू 2y व्हिच इज नियरेस्ट टू द पॉइंट 05 इज. सो यू हैव बीन गिवन फोर ऑप्शंस. व्हेन यू हैव ऑप्शनल क्वेश्चन नो यू नीड नॉट कंप्लीट द टोटल प्रोसेस. आई विल टेल यू व्हेन इट इज ऑन ऑप्शनल क्वेश्चन व्हाट टू डू एंड व्हेन इट इज नॉट एन ऑप्शनल क्वेश्चन व्हाट टू डू. ओके सो हियर व्हाट यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट इज there is a point on the curve which is nearest to. So you can just find out many distances to the point 0,5 from the same curve. But you have to find out the nearest means that point should give you the minimum distance. Okay, so the distance concept you have to use here. Distance between the two points. Okay, so first we will just take the point as x, y. Let the point on the curve, let any point on the curve, okay, on the curve be x, y. Suppose this is a, because we need to write something as the distance, no? That's why I'm taking a, and let b is equal to 0,5. Now what we need to find out is what is the distance ab. Okay, so the distance, we have to minimize this distance. Okay, distance ab will be, how to find the distance between two points? Distance formula, root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. So here you can use x minus 0 the whole square plus y minus 5 the whole square, which is same as root of x square plus y minus 5 the whole square. Now if you are just squaring, you can just delete this root of concept. Okay, so we are just squaring. That will give you ab square, which is equal to x square plus y minus 5 the whole square. Now this we can just take it as some z in order to just identify it, no? So we are just saying, say z is equal to your ab square. So this is x square plus y minus 5 the whole square. Now we will just differentiate this. We have to get the points, no? So first we will just differentiate, that is dz by, again you have two variables, you can just see x and y. So it is difficult to say whether how to differentiate or which variable to be made as the independent variable. So what we have to do is, the curve is given to be x square equal to 2y. So we'll just replace the value of x square as 2y. Okay, so first process is we have to just make it as a function of one variable. So here you will get 2y plus this expansion will give you y square minus 10y plus 25. So that this is y square minus 8y plus 25. Okay, so z is equal to this one. Now it is of one variable. Now you can just differentiate, dz by dy will give you 2y minus 8. Okay, now when you have the second derivative, you can just say that the second derivative should be less than 0, sorry, greater than 0, in order to show that it is the minimum distance, right? So you are just second differentiating twice, you will get this as 2 and this is greater than 0. So you can say that after finding out that point, we will just replace, because it is a constant, I said that greater than 0, but you need to put the point, right? Now we will just, for maxima and minima, what we have to do, you have to just replace it with, that is the first derivative with 0, equate it to 0, which will give you y is equal to 4, right? 2y is equal to 8 or y is equal to 4. Now this y equal to 4, again if you replace here, you don't have any y term. That means you can say that therefore at this point the second derivative equal to 2 alone, right? At the point y equal to 4, you are getting second derivative as 2, which is greater than 0. Therefore the point which you will get will give you the nearest value. Now actually the point you have to find out here, you can just see the option, you have 4 here, that is the value of y is 4. That means you need not find out x in order to say which one will be the answer, right? So answer will be this. But if it is a question, you have to find out the point. At that time you have to just find out what is x equal to also. So x equal to, how you'll get, you have to just replace it in the curve, that is x relation connecting x and y. X square equal to 2y, in that you replace the value of y which you got, so you will get x square is equal to 8, which will give you x as 2 root 2. Okay, so here you have to say that y equal to 4 is a point of minima. Understood? So it is an objective type question, means you have to just go for what is y and that will give you your answer. But if it is a question type, you have to do the rest of the thing also, that is find out x, and therefore the point is, the nearest point is 2 root 2 comma 4. So for this, we will just take this as y is equal to 1 minus x plus x square divided by 1 plus x square, so that differentiating with respect to x will give you 1 plus x square into, you have to use the quotient rule, into the derivative of this will give you minus 1. This is 0. Its derivative is minus 1. Here you will get 2x. So minus 1 plus 2x minus 1 minus x plus x square constant derivative of this denominator v. That is again 1 plus 2x divided by 1 plus x square the whole square. Right? Now expanding, we can cancel many terms. So we'll just expand minus 1 plus 2x minus x minus 2x square minus x square plus 2x cube minus of 1 plus 2x minus x minus 2x square plus x square plus 2x cube divided by 1 plus x square the whole square, which is equal to minus 1 plus 2x minus x minus 2x square minus x square plus 2x cube. For ease of calculation, okay, just to cut out, no, that's why I'm writing like this. Minus 2x plus x plus 2x square minus x square minus 2x cube. So here you can see that which all terms are getting cancelled. X cube term cancel, minus x, minus 2x plus 2x, minus 1 not getting cancelled, then minus 2x square plus 2x square. Here you have an x square term. So you have minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, then plus 4x square minus 2x square. These are the terms left, so that you can write minus 2 plus 2x square in the numerator, and this will give you the same whole square. Now here you can take out minus, so that this becomes 1 minus x square, right? 1 plus x square the whole square. Okay, now equating this to 0, you will get the value as, see here you can write it as minus 2 into 1 plus x into 1 minus x divided by 1 plus x square the whole square. So this one is your dy by dx. Now you have to find out the second derivative. In between, I am just finding out what are the critical points. Okay, for maxima and minima, you are just equating this to 0. You will get 1 plus x into 1 minus x equal to 0, or x is equal to 1 or minus 1. Okay, so these are the critical points. So I'm just now finding out the second derivative. Second derivative, you have d square y by dx square as 1 plus x square the whole square into the derivative of this minus 2 into the derivative of this will give you minus 2x. Okay, minus minus 2 into 1 minus x square into 2 into 1 plus x square into its derivative, which is 1 plus 2x divided by 1 plus x square the whole square the whole square. So you will have whole raised to 4. Okay, now you can see this term is common in both the things as a product, so you can just take out one term. Here you have power 2, here you have power 1. So I am just taking out this. Remaining will be 1 plus x square into, here you will have 4x, correct? Then minus, again this minus will become plus. 2 into 1 minus x square. Okay, 4 into 1 minus x square into 1 plus 2x. This has been taken out. Divided by 1 plus x square the whole raised to 4, so that I can cancel one term here. So this will become as, this will go here, the power will become 3. So here I am getting 4x into 1 plus x square plus 4 minus 4x square into 1 plus 2x divided by 1 plus x square the whole cube. That is 4x plus 4x square plus 4x cube minus, sorry, plus 4 plus 8x minus 4x square minus 8x cube divided by 1 plus x square the whole cube. So here square term, this will get cancelled. Again, these two and 4, and this is left. The change is minus 4x cube plus 12x plus 4. Right now, 1 plus x square the whole cube. So that you will get minus 4 in common. Or else you have to replace, okay, value. X cube minus 3x plus 1 divided by 1 plus x square the whole cube. Now checking at x equal to 1, you will get d square y by dx square is equal to, because we need to confirm which one is giving you the minimum value, because that value we need to substitute there. Okay. Replacing the value, will get minus 4 into 1 minus 3 minus 1 divided by 1 plus 1 whole cube. So that you are getting 12, correct? Minus into minus you are getting, okay, positive. And this is 3 cube, 27. So this is greater than 0. So at x equal to 1, you are getting greater than 0. And checking for at x equal to minus 1, you will get d square y by dx square as minus 4 into, this will become negative, this will become positive, minus 1 divided by 1 minus 1, again positive, the whole cube. Again, what is this giving you? Minus 4, here it is 3 minus 2, 1. So minus 4 divided by 1, okay, minus 4, which is less than 0, right? So at x equal to 1, you are getting greater than 0, and at x equal to minus 1, you are getting less than 0. So which one will give you the max minimum value? You have to check for minimum value, means you have to choose at x equal to 1, right? Therefore, x equal to 1 is a point of minima. And the question is, you have to find the value. That means you have to substitute in this y is equal to 1 minus x plus x square divided by 1 plus x square in order to get the minimum value. Okay, so at x equal to 1, what is y? Y is equal to 1 minus 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1 plus 1. So you are getting 1 by 3. Therefore, the option D is correct. Whenever in the question the boundary is given, you have to use the absolute maxima, absolute minima method. That means you have to check for f of at all the points. That is a critical point which you will get after equating this to 0, that derivative of this to 0, and at 0 and 1 also. So what value is giving you the maximum value that you have to take. Okay, so first we will just take this as y. Now differentiating this with respect to x. This is x raised to n form. So you have to make it as n x raised to n minus 1. So it's 1 by 3 into x square minus x plus 1 the whole raised to 1 by 3 minus 1 into this power. Here you have like this. So what this will give you is 1 by 3 into the power will become minus 2 by 3. So that this is x square minus x plus 1. The whole raised to negative 2 by 3 into 2x minus 1. That means this will come in the denominator, right? 2x minus 1 divided by 3 into x square minus x plus 1 the whole raised to 2 by 3, right? Okay. Now, what we need to do, we have to just equate it. Actually, here the second derivative is not required. Why? Because you have to find the maximum value when the boundary is given. So we will just equate this to 0 so that you will get 2x minus 1 equal to 0 or x is equal to 1 by 2. Right? Now for this, you have to just replace this value as well as the two points 0 and 1. You have to replace in the function. function is this one. So at x equal to 0, what will happen to y? This will become, this is the function, so it is 0 minus 0 plus 1 the whole raised to 1 by 3. So you are getting y as 1 here. At x equal to half, you have y is equal to 1 by 2 the whole square minus 1 by 2 plus 1 the whole raised to 1 by 3. Which will give you 1 by 4 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 the whole raised to 1 by 3. 1 by 4 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 in total will give you how much you'll get. This is 1 by 4. Here you will have plus half whole raised to 1 by 3. And this is 1 by 4 quarter part and half part will give you 3 by 4 part the whole raised to 1 by 3. At x equal to 1, you will get y is equal to 1 square minus 1 plus 1 the whole raised to 1 by 3. So that again you are getting 1. So the maximum value which you are getting is, the options are given as 1 by 3 the whole raised to 1 by 3 A. B is 1 by 2, C is 1 and D is 0. So you are getting the maximum value as 1 where they are not asking. So the answer is C. Okay.